What is going on, guys? Wiser here, and I'm coming to you with a special episode discussing the update. I am here with the man himself, Kadijk. How you doing, my friend?
Hey, man. It's always cool to be here.
Yeah, it is an interesting time for the world of Clash of Clans as well, because the update obviously hit. A lot of people have been asking me, what are our thoughts and what's our perspective on things. So just quickly trying to brainstorm, obviously, with you this afternoon. Pretty much dug up what we could. I mean, we only have so much information thus far, so that's part of the problem, right? You're not going to know until we start seeing more attacks how much of an effect it's going to have on the game. It's probably primarily going to affect Town Hall 10, I would say. I'm not sure if you agree with that, Kadijk.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah. So let's hop in here. Maybe just show a few replays. Obviously, the Prime versus Invict war just happened. Prime dominated. This was the first war for the update. Both sides Town Hall 9 struggle, but Prime's 10s just really shone through and had some ridiculously good attacks. So congrats, OneHive Prime. I will say that right now. Should be doing the recap this evening for it. Anyhow, let's jump in and show a few replays while I kind of discuss some of the things. So I'm just going to go over the new content and then kind of we'll let you chime in here, Kadijk. Obviously, we got the first and foremost is the bowler. It was added to the game. First new unit we've seen since the Lava Hound. And what are your thoughts on the bowler so far?
He's interesting. And I've heard a couple of Town Hall 11s and 10s playing around with him. But he seems even underwhelming at the moment. I'm not too sure. We can't tell yet. I mean, we've all seen the epic replays of Clash with Ash, I believe, and all of the big names on YouTube that are playing around and getting really high percentages on Town Hall 11s.
But yep.
I'm not sure what their place will be in war, in actual three-star strats. We'll have to see. I mean, they're a really niche pick, it seems. I mean, with the Queen Walk getting that... the air defense that you would not get with a queen walk, you can now get with a bowler. So that's a really interesting mechanic, and we'll just have to see, man.
Yeah, we'll have to wait it out. I mean, you don't know. Plus, you absolutely know the unit's probably going to be changed, tweaked and tweaked.
It should be.
It's you never know until you really start seeing it in a lot of wars and stuff and what it can do, because obviously there's groups out there that get the opportunity to just practice attacks 1,000 times over. So we're going to start seeing some very interesting things, I think, from the bowler.
I'm looking forward to it, though, because it really changes the dynamic of Town 10 and 11.
It definitely could. That range is insane. Like, if you think you can pick off an air defense now sitting behind two sets of walls, if you kind of played it right, I mean, that's pretty crazy thought. So we'll just have to see, though, like you said. I mean, you never know until we start seeing it tested. So next thing on my list here, Inferno Tower going up to level 4, actually quite a few couple defenses, and the mortar level 9 both at Town Hall 11. So Town Hall 11 just got even crazier with the Eagle Cannons. Now they got level 4 Infernos and level 9 mortars. That's obviously going to have a bit of an effect.
Absolutely. I think that it's a good change. It makes for the spam witch attacks, especially with the new targeting system of the Inferno. It makes it a lot better to defend. I mean, you will see no more brain dead spamming of witches and getting high percentages. It'll be a lot more skill involved now in Town Hall 11. I think that's a good thing. I mean, it already was possible to 3-star Town Hall 11s if they were a bad base, that is. So now I feel like Town Hall 11 has become the new Town Hall 10, basically.
Yeah, I see the Town Hall levels kind of dividing a little more now. Like, really, Town Hall 11 almost at one point just seemed like a Town Hall 10 plus, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, absolutely.
So I guess we'll see how that goes. Hog Riders, Valkyries, Goblins all get a new max level all at Town Hall 10. That is huge.
That's huge. I love it. I mean, this change is going to change Town Hall 10 forever. I mean, we have too little information right now to actually say what it's going to do. But what I do know, and that's props to the OneHive Prime guys, they got fresh hit triples with Govahos.
Yeah.
I mean, Tunnel 10 triples.
Crazy. Crazy,
it's
crazy.
Crazy. The Velks are so good now. We'll talk about them later a bit, I think.
A little bit, yep.
But, yeah, for now, the level 5s have the same HP as the old level 4s had. I'm pretty sure. I haven't completely checked, but it's about there. And, yeah, it's awesome. They do crazy. So much. Beware for the mass Velk attacks.
I mean, something
might happen.
Something I noted about the Max Hogs is... same, I guess you could say about the Max Valks is that Town Hall 9 CC comps for attacking might change, because I saw quite a few people request Max Hogs as opposed to a Max Golem.
Yeah, that too. It all depends now. It's really interesting for Town Hall 9, actually, because now you can opt for the Max Valks or Hogs if your Golems aren't going to get that far, basically. So with the change to Valkyries, they will run out in front even quicker from the Golems. And so it's a really interesting dynamic. And I really do think that you'll see less and less Max Golems requested for War CC.
For sure. So at Town Hall 11, the Grand Warden Life Aura and the Tome range reduced slightly. So, I think that's kind of a good thing. They're trying to lean away at Town Hall 11 from that mass witch attack we saw so predominant up until this update. Again, I'm not at Town Hall 11, so it's hard for me to comment other than what I see. But from what I see at Town Hall 11, if you can just keep a huge group of witches next to your Grand Warden, then you got a pretty good chance at a 3-star.
Plus, this AI got changed a bit, so it's you have to be very careful now where to place him.
Yeah, which is good, because, I mean, you want it to be some skill involved, right? Not just drop all your troops and wait to hit your Grand Warden ability.
Yeah, but let's just say this about Tunnel 10s and 11s. We don't know yet. That's the honest truth.
Yep.
And we're working on it. I've asked a lot of our Tunnel 10s to help us out to get some content your way and get ready to make a base building video on Tunnel 10. I mean, now is the time to go for it. Yeah, we're trying to get it as quickly as possible, but as I said, it's too early to tell what the different troop levels are going to do, but we're doing our best to get it out as quickly as possible.
Absolutely. So, I mean, Kadijk and I already have plans to do this episode of, we're going to get together with a couple of our top Town Hall 10s and really hash out a lot of things about it. I mean, especially, you know, we just need a little more information on really, like, the Inferno Tower multi-mode acquiring new targets faster, like how big of an effect is that going to have in the long run? We don't know until we get to the long run. So it's coming, guys. It's going to take us a little bit of prep, but definitely we see a lot of good things for Town Hall 10 and things like base building and stuff like that coming up. So Town Hall 9, though, did have some changes as well. Skeleton hit points reduced. Thought that was kind of interesting. I didn't even realize that an Archer Tower prior wouldn't kill a skeleton in one shot.
I'm not sure.
Is that what I was reading?
Probably was with the Warden as well. I'm not sure. But it doesn't matter too much. In the end, it's defending a shot, and an Archer Tower gets a second shot in anyways. So
yeah,
doesn't matter too much.
Not a huge deal. Skeleton's not triggering traps. That's kind of... sucks, I guess, if you think about it, because I definitely at times have thought to bring one witch just for those extra skeletons running around to trigger a bomb.
Yeah, that's a big change, actually. At Town 9, you didn't see many witches anyway. I was personally a fan of them, but right now they're pretty much there to distract only archer towers and cannons, which is okay, but They're really becoming a niche pick at Town 9.
Yeah, absolutely. Expo levels. That went up for all levels, two levels, two to four expos. I think that's going to have quite an effect on the Town Hall 9 game.
Absolutely, yeah. The damage increase is actually massive. It went up by 15 at level 3, which is from 75 to 90. Which is a huge deal.
Absolutely.
Because before, with about four healers, your queen would go down quite quickly with an expo and 1 point defense on her. But now she will go down considerably. That said, there's a healer bug at the moment, which makes three healers more powerful now than before.
Yeah,
four healers would be. So yeah, I'm exploiting it while it's out there, but it will change. And let's stick to the change in the old situation, because that's what it's going back to in the future.
Yeah.
One expo and 1 point defense will get her down quite
quickly. Very soon. Like, I think tonight even, it might actually, by the time this video is released, it might actually already be changed.
Which would be a really good thing. It means that you have to plan your queen walks really carefully, and that's a really cool thing for defense. Ground those expos, maybe.
Yeah.
I mean, with the time constraints, that's the next big thing. Dragon attacks will be less prevalent, and air attacks in general can be defended quite well now. So it's a huge deal. We can actually start grounding expos, which means less and less queen walks. And
And the expos are putting out way more damage.
Yeah. So that's amazing.
I mean, in a nutshell, I was excited as a Town Hall 9 for this update. Because to me, Town Hall 9 is back for base building. And, you know, it really is. I mean, I know things are going to get tweaked still. You know, they don't release an update this big.
Oh, yeah.
Make hot fixes. But I think in general, I said this when the 30 seconds freaking came out. Why did they add it? I know they were worried about the Town Hall 11 and higher game, but. It just killed Town Hall 9 so much. They just didn't. Everything else was enough, right? So
true. The Town Hall 9 game is back. You saw it in the Prime versus Invicta War. And
absolutely.
I've had a lot of defenses all of a sudden in that very war.
Yeah.
It's insane. The 30 seconds really do kill long queen walks.
Yep.
It's going to take some adjusting,
and no question about it.
But so the spread out bases with the extra space actually is a real consideration now, to spread out your bases more, to have longer travel time. Stuff like that actually matters now.
That's
amazing.
For sure. So it's so weird. It's so weird how, like, that was just the norm back then, right? Now it's like, holy geez, attacks got so lazy, in my opinion. Yeah, you know, it's just like, I'm just gonna drop my queen and four healers, let her walk around for 2 minutes, and then I'll send in my hogs. Anyhow,
I'm really excited for the 30 less seconds because Title 9 defense is back.
It really is. And you think about, you still compare it, right? You know, guys are talking about, I do agree. I love the way you cannot drop poisons. There's another thing that happened with this update. You cannot lure out troops and drop poisons on them with none of your units on the field, or they're going to walk out of the poison. So what that means is you just kind of have to go back to like you used to. Just go in and drop the poison when the CC troops come out.
Yeah, exactly. It's either that or lure them out and deal them with them the old-fashioned way,
witches,
for example. And this really encourages people to go in, have poisons down in the correct place, and have wizards behind golems that are tanking the CC troops. It makes it interesting. I mean, especially at Tunnel 8, this is a big thing, because at Tunnel 8, there's not a single base that you wouldn't see people throw in a couple of hogs, get the lure, kill the CC, and there we go.
Yeah, and so it's definitely way... I totally agree with that. The poison spell was so overpowered as is. Like, the fact that troops are going to blindly stand in poison and kill themselves, no. Like, I fully agree with that change.
It's just boring, to be honest.
Yeah, like, there needs to be something to the CC. Like, at least the CC has a little more value now, right? Like,
which is awesome. Yeah, let's just talk about the CC a little bit.
Sure.
Because with troops coming out quicker, I mean, for example, if you have a lot of small troops, there's a fat chance that they might actually stay out of poison range now.
Yep.
I haven't seen it happen too much yet, but I've actually on one of on my Tunnel 8 account, I saw my witch come out of the CC, and it was targeting a golem. That golem died, and she walked back away from the attacking troops. Out of the poison, and then started spawning skellies. I mean, that's amazing.
Or Or your hog you send in for the lure hits a Tesla trap and you don't get the whole CC and then accidentally poison the archers.
Yeah, stuff like that. So it's really interesting, and this forces people to think a bit better about their CC kills, and that's a good thing.
It just it excites me now to really build bases again. I was getting so discouraged, I'm not gonna lie. You build a good base and it's to what, defend once at best. It's
At
just
best, yeah.
yeah, it sucks, So I mean, Valkyries are obviously, I think, are really gonna be predominant now in
Yeah.
not that they weren't to begin with, and that's what I don't fully understand about maybe this update. Oops, I don't want to show this attack.
So Valkyries, they were already the big thing in fair play war communities, and together with dragons mainly those are were the dominant attacks out there. So the dragons with the 30 seconds, they're not as dominant anymore because they most of the time were a time sensitive attack. But the Valkyries now, I mean, if something is good enough to base your attack around and they're making that stronger, yeah, that's just missing the mark in my opinion. But that's what we have to deal with for the coming time. And so with base building, Valkyries are the thing to defend. So when building a base, think out Valkpathing. Start with the basics and then move on towards touching buildings in awkward places. With their immediately spinning, do you want to have buildings touching at all? Stuff like that. So really think carefully about having defenses touching and storages touching. Other trash doesn't matter as much, but yeah, focus on Valkyrie defense because they are going to be the way to go at Tunnel 9.
Like a good little trick sometimes is to have like purposely place your elixir mines or storages that are on the outside together near a wall where kind of near an
Yes.
area, a compartment that you think Valkyries are going to jump into, because sometimes, especially if there's a jump or there's nothing sucking them into the compartment, they'll sometimes stand on a wall to just to get to those double buildings.
Yeah, I've seen a screenshot go around just today that Valkyries were ignoring a jump less than five tiles away to get through a wall to get to two touching buildings. So that's the way to defend the Valkyries most of all, and they die quite quickly now. So
It's
that's
hard.
it's
It's
really
not.
interesting because of wizard towers and Tesla farms and stuff like that, and even CC troops. I mean, I don't know exactly how much one loon drop does. But I'm pretty sure it does most of the HP of one Valkyrie. So if you have a Lunan CC and it gets a shot off through the poison, even that is, it might be end of the raid.
Yeah.
So it's a good thing to think about a high concentration of firepower in a small area while the defenses are still not touching, and that can actually kill Valkyries. I actually failed a raid in a recent war, and that was because with Valkyries, and that was because my Valkyries were hitting a storage, an elixir storage, and there was a Tesla farm and an expo hitting them, and they died through a
Oh,
heal.
yeah.
So it's possible to defend them because of their lesser HP, but it's tough. It's gonna be tough.
Absolutely tough. I mean, it was already tough. Like double jump gobo-ho is so hard to defend in like it, as a base as a whole, right? Without forgetting all the other principles. And it potentially just got even more difficult, so.
Yeah, and one of my ideas versus Govaho, one of the best ways to defend it beforehand already was to have all of their hogs die to spring traps. I mean, I cannot stress enough how important spring traps will be in the coming future, because if the hogs die too early, the Valkyries will get hit on for the rest of the raid, and you'll either run out of time or the Valkyries will just die and your raid will end. So when building a base, focus on the spring traps and Valkyrie pathing, I would say, and the rest comes later.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, well, I think that about covers it for now until we can get this Town Hall 10 sort of guide or whatever you want to call it, or whatever we decide to call it, together. Unless you had anything else you wanted to add?
The wizard towers. We forgot
about
those.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. Yes.
They got more HP, and that's a really nice thing. It's something that's very experimental still, but it might be an idea to group up on them, and they will be even more deadly to balloons now, and also versus hogs. You can have, if there's a couple of wizard towers together, you're forcing a heal basically. So that might be worth playing around with a bit. I haven't yet. I will in the future. But yeah, use them as storages basically. Same goes with expos. They might be a really good combination now.
So, well, they're you know, it's, I like it because a lot of times the way I build my bases is I have them protected, but on the outskirts, because generally my air defense are more towards the core, so I want them out of that range slightly. So they're usually on the outside of my base. So having those extra hit points, right? I wonder if two balloon drops still destroy it. They must.
I haven't checked, but I'm not completely sure. I would expect so, but I'm not 100% sure.
Yeah.
But then again, this is worth experimenting with. So.
And this is what we're talking about. Like, there just needs to be a little bit of time. People need to play with things. We need to see things for ourselves before we make any definitive long-term comments on how it's going to affect base building and attacking and all that. So.
Exactly, and then I think we've had it all, basically.
So. Yeah, for sure. Okay, well, thanks for coming out, Kadijk. Appreciate the info.
You're welcome, man.
Absolutely. I know the viewers appreciate it. They love hearing your soothing Dutch voice. So that'll do it for your wisdom from Wiser. Just trying to help it bag that next tree start. Till then, we're out.